Hurry up!
Since when are we running on your schedule now? I was going to reply to a client and then I'll be it. You'll have my undivided attention.
Premium content for YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good morning, YouTube. Good afternoon, YouTube.
Is it the afternoon?
It is afternoon, Dickhead.
Oh, it's not.
Okay, good morning, YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
The week has been... Look at your ankles.
Don't my ankles.
The week so far has been...
It's been good.
Wednesday today, as opposed to our normal Fridays.
Yeah, well, someone was busy this Friday, so we had to reschedule.
Busy was busy.
Am I busy?
Oh, yeah, I am busy this Friday.
You supposed to remember your appointments, mate.
Yeah.
Yeah, week has been good. Nothing really exciting to report, really. Keegan, help me out here.
What's been going on this week? Man, my week's all a blur. Nothing's been good. Like, just...
Have you had a good positive attitude this week?
I've always got a positive attitude, James.
Life is good. This week, you actually have been pretty good this week.
Yeah.
Not as grumpy.
Exactly.
Keegan, grumpy? No.
I finally got to sleep over the weekend, so I'm feeling good.
Nice. What are your plans for today?
Keegan's going to train.
You're not training?
Nothing.
Right. Well, I'll be training arms.
James is not injured, he's just not training. Just a little bit cooked.
Yeah.
Is that the way to say it?
Yeah. Personal day.
Yeah.
Just having a me day, a bit of me time.
Yeah.
It's all about that balance.
There's no such thing as fucking balance.
Isn't there?
No.
I like to think I've got pretty good balance.
Oh. Fucking
mainly with my diet.
Yeah, I know, and it shows. He actually looks pretty good.
Yeah,
I gave him a compliment before.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Like, so
the average person would be happy with that.
With biz?
The busy bod.
I'm happy.
So the average person would be happy with that biz?
Yep. Mm. I am the average man.
Well, I'm about to hit some arms.
Mm.
Busy's about to try and make me look good.
Mm-hmm.
And then we just got a whole afternoon's worth of check-in, so a fair few athletes coming in the Savo, so...
It's good.
Pretty standard day, man.
Any new athletes?
Not today. I've got a couple new ones starting towards the end of the week, so... Got coach up in Queensland has joined the team, wants to prep for a show and stuff like that, so
that's cool.
Yeah, but like we've actually had the team's actually grown pretty quickly. Like the coaches downstairs, they're getting absolutely pumped at the moment, so me and James are being quite selective who we take it on at the moment, just already quite full with our calendars, and we just need to start prioritizing ourselves a bit, like, you know, kind of recognizing where we are as coaches and be selective in who we take on. Like, not that we think we're too good for people, but
you gotta ration out your time.
Well, you got coaches downstairs that are more than capable for 90% of the people that are reaching out. Mm. So you're like,
it also comes down to is like some of the athletes we have need more of our time. So like we go to on the gym floor, for example, and it's helping them execute things more efficiently for when they're on stage. So it's just be able to have more time available to spend with them rather than people that just, you know, stepping on stage or taking things to a higher level isn't a priority, so to speak. So, you know, we have G, Davina and Hayden are more than capable of, you know, achieving great results. So,
pretty much. Unless someone's in prep at the moment, we're not taking them on because it's just, well, so little time, man. We're about to go into show season, so we don't want to absolutely just hammer ourselves and then get in the show season and not be able to show up for the shows 100%. So, yeah. Ourselves in the ground again.
Have you recovered?
Have I recovered?
Yeah. It was funny, like, Liz Thornhill, Keegan's mum, my second mum, sends an email the other week and it's like, how's your health? Said, walked into Keegan, I'm like,
physical or mental?
How do we answer this question? Mentally, we've lost the plot.
That was gone a long time ago. Every day on the verge of an emotional breakdown.
You can tell the days that Keegan's having a good day because it's like looking up, you know, vehicles, cars, and it's like it's not like your average car. What were you looking at the other day?
Camaros.
No, Lamborghinis.
Yeah.
So oh, damn.
Yeah, and we had discussions on what colour we'd get.
What was it before that? It was Skylines, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was the brand new squat. I like jab cars, man. I just like things to go fast.
He was like, yeah, that'd be good. It's like, you won't fucking fit into it.
Yeah, what flavour's that one?
The tropical gummy.
Can I smell it? Smells nice.
Yeah, it's a lot nicer than the cola one.
Mm. What's this?
It's a fine eight.
Is that a pre-workout?
It's a fat burner, but I want the caffeine, so I'm going to go the swole mate for the pump.
Yeah. Are you doing an ASM plug? Where do you get all these subs from, Keegz?
Oh, of course, ASM.
Can you get them online?
You can.
Yeah? What about, is it local? I think Frankston's pretty local to us, isn't it?
I'm just a little bit local, James, yes. Yeah.
Terrelgan's pretty good too.
Team Indo.
Yeah.
That's the discount code.
Is that the discount code?
Yeah.
Do you drop that at the counter when you purchase your products?
Oh, I'm a big deal, mate. They know who I am.
Evolve. That's a great brand too. Is that by ASM?
Yeah, it is their own brand, yes. Yeah.
Who do they see when they go to Frankston?
Norman Mandy.
Andy? What about Terrelgan?
Adam.
What about Matt Waverley?
I don't fucking know. I've never been to that one.
No.
Oh, Jazz works there.
Okay.
Hmm.
Or Brett, they asked for Brett.
Yeah, Brett will come up.
See, ASM have got all the locations around Melbourne, don't they?
Fuck you, Waker.
Doing a better job than the actual sponsored athlete.
They do look after us, ASM. All their products are really beneficial too. They've got health, sports performance. Even got hydration now too. Did you see the boys using them over?
Have you had sugar? have you fucking had sugar today?
How's it taste? No, thank you. No, thank you.
It's good.
Look, watch this before and after. Swole by Swole Mate.
Yeah.
Is it an ASN shaker?
It is, just ASN's rubbed off it.
I was going to make something smart, but I won't.
So I think you've said enough, James.
Don't tell you guys.
Wait, do it again.
I'm not ticklish.
Do it again. Face. Okay, this is Busy, everyone. Say hi, Busy.
Hello.
Let's watch Busy's titties jiggle. Imagine Busy with a bit of pace going.
What are you doing? Keegan, you saying this shit?
Oh, I'm saying it.
No. You liked the way I jiggled, didn't you, boy? I was on this machine before.
Where?
And the plates you're putting on right now are my max.
Really?
Just doing a bit of a warm up, are ya?
20 kilo aside was your max. Fuck, you need to come spend more time with us, Next Friday we've got Matt O'Reilly and James McIntosh coming down for a session. So they're from up in the Gold Coast. And we know Matt pretty well through the obviously WBFF and being a pro and all that. James, I've spoken to him a few times on Insta. He's one of the head educators for Prescript. So he's been following our stuff and he just loved the whole setup of this. So he wrote through and we set this up saying he wanted to come down for a session. So they're down in Melbourne for something next week, so they want to come out next Friday and film a session with us, so it should be fun because Maddie's fucking strong too, so yeah, it's always good when you get around guys like that. I'm one of those people I don't really need a goal. Like, I'm not more so motivated towards work towards something, like I'm more like how people talk about loving the process. For me, getting into this lifestyle was always about proving that I'll do what others won't. Like, I've never really claimed to be a great athlete. I claim to outwork everyone. So for me, I pride myself so much on like what I'm willing to sacrifice that the goal just, it happens, but I'm not really working towards anything, if that makes sense. Like, I know I want to get bigger, but there's never been a time where I'm like, I want to be this size, or I want to be a pro athlete or stuff like that. I generally just love coming in every day and living this lifestyle to an extreme that most people won't, because that's kind of what I get off on. Like, so for me, it's always been about, I'm working towards outworking everyone, as opposed to I'm working towards a size that I want to be. And that's why I find it hard to relate to people when they're like, oh, I need a goal. Because like, why? Like, it should just be a standard of living that we want to live to and get about living it. You know, so I find doing abs in the off season helps stabilize my back heat. So when I'm doing my heavy squats and that, I keep throwing my back out because I've actually fractured in my sacrum joint. So when I'm loading heavy, it shifts and sends me spine crooked. Whereas by keeping the core strong throughout the off season, it tends to hold my back a lot better and I don't need so many regular chiro visits. So yeah, it's a big thing I'm working on this off season because like all bodybuilders, most off seasons we get very lazy with the ab training and only do it when we're in prep again. So actually making a conscious effort to at least twice a week hit 3 sets of abs to keep the core strong. 10,000 a day.
A day, day.
Yeah. Well, 10,000 what they estimate you need offer, you know, optimal strength and that, and especially when you enhance lifters and that, just make sure we look after the heart health. So about 10,000 is what you need just to make sure you keep on top of that. And I definitely reckon that hitting 10,000 sets a day is allowing me to deal with the weight that I am at the moment. Like, I am the heaviest I've ever been, and like, even though I can feel that weight and the fact that like, I just feel heavy moving around, my health's actually a lot better than what I would be expecting at this kind of weight. Like, I'm not so out of breath doing things. Like, you know, last time I hit like close to 140, like I'd walk up a flight of stairs, be gassed as fuck. Like, whereas now, like, you know, I'm actually half functional. Like, don't feel like such a fat cunt just moving around.
A little bit flash.
Busy, can you hear me?
What about when I want to take my shirt off, Biz?
You're not going to take your shirt off on camera, right? Are you really going to take your shirt off?
But yeah, tie band around that because that will help initiate the...
He's in game mode.
You what?
What?
I can't say that, remember?
Why? I said game, not game mode. Game. G-A-M-E.
Enunciate your words better. Don't say anything weird out there because I'm still going to be able to hear it.
Enunciate, you mean articulate?
No, enunciate.
And articulate better.
Articulate, yes. But what I meant was enunciate.
What? Who uses that in...
Enunciate.
Yeah. Who uses that word?
Me. Smart people, obviously. I'm going to be able to hear. I don't know. I wonder if you will be able to hear me, actually. I don't know. I haven't tested the range of them.
Don't you have headphones so you can hear what we're saying?
You going to ditch your keys upstairs or are you just going to carry them?
For audio purposes, please leave the keys upstairs.
Well, you can't hear anything anyway.
Yeah, that's a good point. We're mic'd up.
You need to articulate better. Enunciate your words.
Hurry up!
Since when are we running on your schedule now?
Up!
I was going to reply to a client and then I'll be it. You'll have my undivided attention.
I had a great session.
Please, true loud. They come with like little afros you can put on them to stop the wind.
Why don't you put them on?
Because I wanted to test it, just see what it's like now. See how like.
So we'll be out here and all you hear is like.
Enunciate your words.
Better than
the hike.
Yeah, 7-day hike where you sleep in the fucking on the side of the track and like, who the fuck would want to do that?
Not my fucking deal.
Busy would.
Yeah, I'd do it.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Sure. Yeah. Eating noodles out of a packet.
But it's the fact you pay to go walk.
All noodles coming out of a packet. For the rest of the day.
I feel like you asked us that about 10 times a day.
Yeah, because it's a good cue.
Huh?
No, I come back and you guys have attitude. Do you guys have a shit training session or something?
What?
What did you train?
Arms.
Oh.
What were you doing?
I just told you I went to the supermarket.
An hour and a half.
Yeah, well, the time you drop stuff at home and...
We'll go sniffing cereal boxes.
Ooh. That'd be nice, actually. No.
James does that in prep.
Fucking... Hello. How are you?
Just goes browsing the cereal aisle to see what he would have. Tell me I'm lying.
That was my first prep.
Huh?
My first prep. I didn't sniff.
Well, no, but you spend all your time in the cereal aisle.
Contemplating all the options, yes. hoping that one day my coach would actually be generous enough and, you know, look at my physique and go, cool, he actually needs some carbs and we might need to put some cereal in there.
Yeah, nah.
Hey! Push off!
Enjoying the sun in our big black hoodie.
Is it black or is it navy?
Definitely black.
Keegan?
It's black, mate.
Fucking black.
Look at you guys fucking questioning. I was just asking a question. Both of you, get off the fucking swole, mate. Jesus. That's swole mate from Alpha Breed, by the way.
Only for true alphas. That's what it says on the thing. Alphas only.
Why's the femboy got it then?
Oh. He didn't.
Hey?
He was too scared to have it.
Exactly, femboy.
Yeah. Beater.
Guys. You walk in front.
No, you walk in front.
I don't trust you.
I don't trust you.
Busy one more time.
James doesn't know how to handle it.
What?
Someone else on the team is as annoying as you.
Yeah. And Keegan just puts up with it. Busy's a little bit easier.
That was a nice walk.
Yeah, it was very pleasant. Thank you.
You got
client check-ins here? It's got about an hour, so I might smash a meal and then I'll check out that vlog and, you know, make sure you did a good job.
Yeah, is this the new one?
Yeah.
Yeah, 17.
Oh, so we actually...
What happens in 17? I don't remember.
You guys.
I know, the delay in getting these vlogs is fucking...
He's about 2 weeks behind.
Yeah.
Mm. So, just so the audience knows, the reason why it's so dark in here right now is because James has recently started watching the Batman movies. He's gotten so into it that he says that he wants to really embody the presence of Bruce Wayne. Therefore, when he's at work, he works in the darkness. Isn't that right, James? Oh, silence, yes. Silence, very Batman-like. Batman, yes.
The emo one?
The good Batman.
The latest one?
The emo one.
He's emo, yeah?
Yeah.
You don't reckon?
I mean, no, I just think he's Batman in Gotham. Do not spill shit on the new microphone.
Well, now you tell me. Put my drink down. If I'm Batman, what are you?
The Joker.
You are not the fucking Joker.
I'm pretty sure I can annoy you like the Joker.
What?
Pretty sure I can annoy you like the Joker.
What did you say before? Enunciate your words, busy. Articulate. What the fuck have you had today? What the fuck have you had today?
Oh, don't do that.
Why?
Because.
What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
What are you doing for the rest of the day? Batman? What have you got on for the rest of the day?
What's with the light?
Well, I can't fucking see you. What are you doing? Can you please give me some informative content here? No?
Yeah, we can do that. Okay. Should we start again, Biddy? Morning has been productive.
You can leave the room, you got a microphone on.
Oh, okay, good. Fuck.
So, morning's been productive.
Ooh, it smells like fucking chips out here. Morning's been productive. We had some client check-ins. Checked in with Courtney, who is... what, about fucking 9 weeks out from the WBFF? That's the Gold Coast show. She's doing fitness. She make a heap of adjustments to her nutrition or training because the way she's progressing is great. She's on track. She's already fairly conditioned at the moment, so it would just be refining things leading into show to maintain a little bit of fullness. Especially with female athletes, the leaner they get, sometimes things can start flattening out, so like glutes and stuff like that. So it's just maintaining fullness there.
Cool background picture, bro. It's very artistic of you. Whoa.
Yeah, perfectly timed.
That's my bad, man.
Also, had a bit of a chat to Dave. That's one of my clients who's doing WBFF, but he's just sent a heap of videos of him doing chess movements, as you can see here. And it's look, it can be very beneficial in terms of seeing how an athlete is training, especially when they're not in our facility. So we can obviously see, one, the intensity, but also the exercise execution. So the chest on Dave is probably one of his weaker areas, and we need to bring up, especially leading into the last bit of the show, because he tends to flatten out through there. So we're just looking at his movement pattern, and just sort of refining things here. So obviously just some key cues through the movement. So like I'm driving through his heels, looking at his wrist position, and also through his lat activation through the pressing movement there.
Bag of dicks and feel exhausted. It'll stop the body fatigue, because that way thyroid function doesn't slow down, she'll just keep dropping all the weight in. So once you get someone lean, you use refeeds. A lot of people try doing too early prep and they just fuck it, they slow themselves and get lean. So
what are you doing?
What am I doing? I just caught up with Duffy. And Duffy's just dropped half a kilo of fat mass in the week, so that's good. So now about to call Dylan. He's a fiery on the other side of the city, and see how he's doing. Then I've got Elle, she's over in Western Australia. And then we've got Braden, Jasmine, and Josh Thom tonight.
How do you go like pinch test wise with clients that are, you know, on the other side of the city that can't come in?
We don't pinch them.
You don't?
So we do it all through photos and circumference measurements and that.
Okay.
So, because, man, pinch tests, they're a point of data, but they're not 100% accurate either. So people that are coming local, obviously they like the pinches because they see some numbers. But really, like for most of the people, and especially most of our online clients being more prep based, it's all on a body image. So like we track their weight, their photos, their circumference measurements, and then we're just really just diet them down so they look a certain way. So in all honesty, I reckon I prefer to coach people online because they focus on the right shit. Like, because all they've got is they've got the circumference measurements and photos to go off, they focus on how they're looking. Whereas people that come to us face to face, they get too hooked on numbers of pinches. So it's a bit like the scales, man. There's so many variables in it. Like, you know, are they holding more water that day? Is it a different time of day? Like, you know, if they had fuck all sleep that night, that will all affect their pinch test. And they get so hooked on, like, you know, we might set a goal, like, oh, we want them about 44 mil in their pinches. They might get to 44 mil though, and we're sort of like, image wise, we need them leaner. But in their head, they've hit 44 mil. It's all good, they're lean enough. So it's trying to get people to understand, especially when prepping for shows, that like, it's a look. There's no data metric that gives us what's going to be presented on stage. So the online people I tend to find easier because they just focus on the right shit. Like, how do I look? Like, when I'm posing, does anything jiggle? And like, you know, if they're posing, nothing jiggles, they look tight, you're like, brilliant, that's what we're presenting to stage. So yeah, it takes a bit more from us, like obviously learning, because we've had to look at a million photos, assess body types, see what's going on, shit like that, and learn to interpret what we're seeing. But like, we've been doing this that many years now, man, that it's piss easy. I actually, even with our face-to-face clients, I judge their photos more than I judge their pinches.
Vlog's sake, do you want to tell the camera what we just did there?
Are we putting that on the vlog?
Well, not that whole thing, but we can. You can just tell me what we just did.
Well, that's a good point, Busy.
Yeah.
So I just had a client from South Australia who sent some video through, similar to what we discussed earlier in the vlog. If you want to go back.
3-1.
Hi, Luke.
That's Luke.
That's Luke.
Sup, Luke?
Yeah. Wave. Yeah. So yeah, we just looked at some movement patterns of hers, and then we're just sort of filming some movements to send to her to just sort of, so what we can focus on. So we're focusing on more lat development, so it's getting her to focus on scapular depression. So she's initiating lats rather than sort of that upper back rhomboid trap area and stuff like that, where she's very developed through. We can initiate more activation through that lat. Okay, so hopefully she can take those videos, apply it to her training. And next week we see an improved version of those, or improved execution. I should reiterate, she's in South Australia, so hence the reason why I'm sending videos back to her. Obviously, like, people are being coached online, it's very easy for them to, you know, just
do the training, but they could be executing things poorly or not the best of their ability. So that way, seeing videos and stuff allows us to actually see their intensity and how the execution has actually been applied.
Yeah, Kevin brought that in for Keegz this morning.
Yeah, it was that for
see?
Premium content for YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Brandon went well. He's up 700 grams, had me concerned when he first jumped on the scales, but his pinches are down, he's actually up in lean mass. So Braden's got a very physical job though too, so his lean mass and that will fluctuate depending on how much water he's got in, how physical his days have been that too. So he does jump quite a lot on a week-to-week basis. But when Braden first started with us, man, like his metabolism was fucked. Like his off-season calories were like 1,700 calories. Like, I could not get him any fucking higher than that. Whereas now, like, he's holding pretty fucking lean and he's sitting on 3,500 calories. So, yeah, he's come a long way since when he started, because, like, there was a good 12 months there we just could not work his food up, man. Like, his body just loved fucking starving. And then we did a prep and he ended up on, like, proper starvation calories in the prep, but his body handled it. Like, he had no negative responses for eating such low calories. And then coming out of show and actually now on his reverse diet, we've got his calories sky high. And yeah, 3,500 is the most we ever worked him up on, but considering it's like three times what we started him on, yeah, it's a pretty sick outcome.
Yeah. I'm well. What's been going on?
Same old.
Same old.
Oh, yeah.
Always good, you
know? A little too.
Like, still getting far leaner through this lower stomach and tightening up heaps through your oblique. And your quads are just looking fucking awesome. Well, even like side on, like these lines through the glutes and how much lean are you getting through there? So when was that?
That was last week. Unless this week.
That's a week?
Yeah. Fuck and yeah. Then even from...
Yeah, so it's all the fullness of the glute. Yeah. Fuck yeah. Much tighter in the lower back too.
Yeah.
Through the back, hamstrings are looking fuller.
Yeah.
That's good. Nice. You just shot nearly 1% body fat. Your lower back and quad both dropped about 2 mil.
Yeah, yeah. I definitely felt it and seen it, yeah.
Well, your photos show you how much lean your lower back is and they dropped 2 mil. Yeah. And quads, yeah, massive drop. So you're actually down about 5 mil in your pinches.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
I'm Batman.
Wait, say again?
No, I'm not saying.
Please, one more time.
Fuck that.
Please, one more time.
I missed it.
I wasn't ready.
No, no.
Don't you fucking raise your hand at me, boy.
Mate, do you want to talk about what happened out there?
Do you want to talk about what happened out there? What happened out there, James?
Mate, you're the professional MMA fighter and you fucking got your ass handed to.
Batman riff. I'm going to go watch Batman tonight and I can chuckle.
No, you won't.
No, I won't.
You won't.
Yeah, what time are you finishing?
8 o'clock, I think.
That's so cute.
Half days.
Yes, mate. What time do you start tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
I was just looking at your fucking... What is that? What is that?
I don't know.
6:30.
Okay.
What time are you in?
5.
Oh, so sleep ins then?
First one, 5:30.
I'm 5 from Friday.
Me too, same! Coffee and McDonald's! Busy, you gonna join us?
Mickey D's, you reckon?
Mickey D's for breakfast on a Friday morning? Friday special? Isn't that what everyone does?
No.
Workplace?
No.
Friday breakfast? No. Catered? Company expense?
Huh. Yeah, I'll come.
Okay.
Yeah, free food.
You start at 5 though.
If an Indomitable's paying for 5, fuck it, I'll be there at 4:30, G.
Okay.
Free Maccas, say less.
Coffee, hash browns,
hot
bacon.
Cakes.
Ooh.
Mm. What? With a little whipped butter on it and shit. That's see you, James.
See you, bye. Thanks for coming.
Good seeing you.
See you, bye.
Enjoy your night.
Follow me and have a piss,
Is that where you're going?
Just follow me to hang a piss.
Ah, cool. Laters.
Hey, man.
When's this weekend, right?
Yeah, wedding's Friday.
4x6.
The clothes still fit?
I don't know.
You haven't tried them on yet?
Nah, he wouldn't let me take him home because he doesn't trust me not to bring him.
What are we down?
5.5 mil.
Like, yeah.
Down 1.4 kilo fat mass.
A fat?
All fat, man.
Sick!
And like, some of your pinks is a pretty decent drop, say, like, your subscap was down huge.
Put you on now, I've got just a phone call with Liv.
Yeah, nice.
So, but I'll be on the phone with her for about 45 minutes because she's got a lot of questions, so.
So is that it for the day then?
Yeah, pretty much, like, Liv's my last one, so she's, what, 8 weeks out from, 8 weeks out from WBFF? I'm gonna get my weeks right. Yeah, she's 8 weeks out from WBFF, so jump on, see how she's going. She's had a massive weight drop last night. She took about 700 grams overnight, so.
Shit, good on you.
Yeah, she's well on track, so check in with her, make sure everything's right, but she's someone very much an overthinker, so I spend a lot of time with her just keeping her calm around the situation at the first WBFF show, so just making sure she's feeling good with it all. But yeah, finish off with her and then shoot home for the night. Another massive day tomorrow.